Welcome everybody to MSI Dragon Battle Finals, best of three between HellRaisers and Team Hehe. Both of these teams came into the finals with some of the most interesting strats I have seen in the MSI Dragon Battle series. Both of these teams in the semifinals, well, Hehe actually, we saw them in the quarterfinals do something that was pretty interesting, but in their semifinal match, they actually ran with a one-position Train Protector and went all global around it, Ancient Apparition, Zeus, and Spirit Breaker being the main gank duo with Darkseer thrown in there, because why the hell not? And then HellRaisers. HellRaisers, who ran an aggro Enigma Tri-Lane. Man, this is game is going to be having probably some of the most interesting drafts you will see all night. So let's jump into it, shall we? HellRaisers versus Hehe. Starting off here, pretty normal for HellRaisers with an SF and Rubik pickup for them. But Hehe have actually got themselves a Spirit Breaker and Darkseer in their hands. The combination which they ran in their semifinal match.
10 seconds remaining.
Where they pushed a
five.
Where they pushed
remaining.
A Spirit Breaker Darkseer aggro dual lane.
Reserve time.
It was weird. It was funky. It was kind of fun to watch. So we're probably going to be seeing that again here, unless for some reason he backed down from that strategy and decided to run for Sorry about that, guys. A little bit of
Radiant team pick.
A little bit of mic interference there.
Dire team
apologies.
Pick.
Anyway, unless they back down and run like a Spirit Breaker as a four position, which I doubt it. Troll Warlord going to be grabbed by HellRaisers again. Pretty typical for the current meta, but Hehe have shown we are anything but normal. They go for Lina pickup. That hero's actually been seeing a lot of popularity, and it is excellent versus the Shadow Fiend, so I don't mind it whatsoever. It's also not bad versus the Troll, because
remaining.
If you get that Aghanim's, Troll, even if he has the BKB, will be
remaining.
Feeling the heat of that Laguna Blade.
Reserve time.
So HellRaisers now going to be banking on what I would only presume would be their 4 position. There is still plenty of offlaners to be picked up, so I think they can afford to leave the offlaner on the table right now. You still have Clockwork, Centaur, Phoenix.
10 seconds remaining.
Lion.
I can't actually think of what else, but hey, there's at Radiant least 3 offlaners that are
pick.
All valid here in this match. So Hehe may be able to ban out one of them, but there's still going to be something good left in the pool. Lion is going to be their choice of pickups here, a nice solid disabler versus the Spirit Breaker. And that's kind of what you need. You kind of need to be able to have a heavy disabler versus a Spirit Breaker when he comes in and charges you.
Remaining.
If you can have a Blink Dagger on that line, he's also going to be a pretty proficient ganker versus Lina, leading with that instant hard disable hex.
Dire team
Ancient
back.
Apparition. Curious. Are they actually going to go for it? Are they actually going to go for the Train Protector one position? It could be real. They won't have a Zeus this time around. That was a huge part of the potency of that lineup,
remaining.
Was having the triple global ulties.
5 seconds remaining.
But, I don't know. Is Hehe? I can't
time.
Think of why they would run the Ancient
Five
Apparition otherwise.
Remaining.
I don't think Ancient Apparition is a particularly strong support here.
Radiant team ban.
And HellRaisers do
Dire
not ban away
pick.
The Train Protector. Oh, wait. Sorry. I missed that. They banned their Train Protector away in the first one, too. My apologies. I didn't actually notice that until now. And they also banned away the Bristleback. I think that was actually a great ban since Train Protector's already taken out, so it's fine. HellRaisers now get an offlaner of their choice. It's not Magnus, but it can be any of the heroes that I was talking about before. Clockwork, Centaur.
10 seconds remaining.
Phoenix wouldn't be terrible in this game.
5 seconds remaining.
It's not a whole lot of attack speed heroes. Lina's pretty much the only one with Fiery Soul.
Reserve time.
Brewmaster.
Oh, Brewmaster, okay.
Radiant
they pick up that big team fighter for their offlane. And what do we got? Hehe. What's their carry? Oh, it's so hard to call because, like, how do you actually,
Naga
like,
Siren.
Naga Siren? Naga Siren? Well, technically, Naga Siren does set up Lina and Ancient Apparition and the Darkseer. It's not the old school where you can vacuum the units who are slept, but it still can set up the Darkseer to lay down the wall preemptively and vacuum immediately afterwards. Then you have an Ice Blast and a Lina Stun laid in. If you can actually hit that combo, that's a wipe right there. That's a wipe. So let's get into it, shall we, guys? Our first match of... whoops.
Prepare for battle.
Whoops. Messed up my overlays somehow. Anyway, our first match of this best of three finals. Hehe versus HellRaisers. We should be running a defensive tri lane around the Troll Warlord with an offlane Brewmaster and an SF mid lane. The only other difference that we could see from HellRaisers would be maybe them putting a support with the Brewmaster, which actually looks like what they may do here with PSM joining Brew. You probably don't fully lane that, but you could probably just do it for the first few minutes. Especially, actually, you could keep it that way if you know that the aggro dual lane is coming out from Hehe with the Darkseer and the Spirit Breaker, which I can only presume that they know what's going on after that Tree and Protector ban in the first one, too. Uh-oh. Net onto Troll. The first pickup here is going to be going the way of Hehe. Sorry, I was fixing some stream things there, but Yarn the Slayer manages to grab the kill. Whoops. Coon, are they really going for this? They're going for round two here. Dread, he's got the impale, but he gets hit by the stun first. Now he's going to be netted up again. Oh, God. The fake back. The fake back is real. They're not actually going to get the kill, though. The boots first on Dread is enough to keep him ahead of that Ion Shell. And he will be good. First blood picked up by Hehe, but no second blood. Who's picking up this bounty rune? Oh, Spirit Breaker, of course, trying to get that faster level 2, so if necessary, he can roam around a bit. Sorry, guys. I just got to fix some... our stream wasn't assigned to this match, so... there we go. Now it should be assigned. Now it should be all good. So the aggro dual lane, exactly what we expected. The Ion Shell spam with the Spirit Breaker taking some last hits and trying to get to that level 2, which he now has. Meanwhile, the bottom lane is going to be the Rubick and Brewmaster going up against the Naga Siren. Naga Siren, who already went for Ensnare first. She did get the first blood, though, so I suppose that makes up for it. Ancient Apparition, that's the hero that they wanted. Telekinesis, throwback here into the clap. They should be able to get the kill. The Ensnare is holding the Brewmaster in, but PSM still has the right clicks to finish off the Ancient Apparition. 1-1 as HellRaisers tie up the score with that sneaky gank. Oh, goddamn, actually gets caught here by a stun and a nuke, but Hook didn't feel confident going in for that kill. The Spirit Breaker could have chased him down, though. Feels like a bit miscommunication. If Hook had stuck around or just, like, kept running up with the SF, they could have been able to dive that tower, the stun into another Light Strike array, and they would have killed the SF. But missing out on that opportunity. 2-minute rune. What's happening top lane? Knee is run down by the Troll. He will end up dying. Throws an Ion Shell down on Mantis. All right. That's something. Regen here in the bottom lane. PSM is coming around, though. Hook, you better run yourself straight up, my friend. He does not, and now he will die.
Better to burn out than fade away.
So another pickoff for HellRaisers. All of a sudden starts off with first blood for Hehe. But once the laning phase starts for real, HellRaisers show their dominance with 3 quick kills. And the first 2.5 minutes of this game. Regen is going to be picked up by our Ancient Apparition.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Lays down some right clicks on the Rubik, but not enough to get the kill, obviously. I'm not sure how I feel about this Nagasaur. I mean, it sets up the teamfight combo, sure, but... Oh, dive there in the top lane. Looks like they get the troll. Goon takes some damage underneath the tower, but it'll be fine. Anyway, I'm feeling like... I'm kind of feeling like it's going to set them up for team fights, but it's not going to be a good enough carry. You get what I mean? I don't know. Bottom lane, Yara and the Slayer. Are they actually going to go for that kill? Oh, they already telekinesis. So never mind. Back up to top lane. We got to be seeing more action here. You know what's going to happen. Surge. They hit the axes, but of course he's not slowed down. The impale misses. Good dodge there from Nihis. Making Dread think twice. Dread, by the way, is not playing the SF. This time around, anyway. Ion Shell. They're going to try and fight. Of course, the miss percentage is making this difficult, but they can go for Dread. Oh, the bump there gets the bash, but he really wants Mantis. He's got another charge, though. Will go for Dread, who does not have enough mana. And will be taken out here by the Iron Shell. No, the miss! The 50% miss is too strong. The Surge, he will get ahead. Enough with that magic wand. He is good. Nice deny there. Quip? Cupe? Quip? I don't know. I don't know how to pronounce his name. But he gets the deny and the haste rune. Nice Orb of Venom pickup there from the Brewmaster. I like that quite a bit. In fact, I would like to see that item on the Spirit Breaker. Of course, he's really underfarmed right now. He doesn't even have boots. You can't ask him for too much. Goon chase down. How's our middle lane doing? 30-4 compared to the 33-34-3 rather. So the Lina is slightly behind in CS, but Lina does have the opportunity to get the kill. If she lands a stun, it's pretty much a guaranteed kill on Goddamn. Thanks to all that burst damage of the Laguna Blade. So the possibility here of turning the tables. Goddamn, better be careful. Jeez, stuck around for quite some time. Another nuke? Oh, boy. Nuke one. He doesn't have enough for a Laguna Blade. Nuke two? No. He can't do this. Hook fortunately realizes that and backs up at the right time. But he just lost control of the lane once again because of that. And for seeing how, like, running dual lanes versus dual lanes, normally there's a lot of action in the early game. We did see it at first, but things have certainly calmed down in the last few minutes. Dive in. Do they really want to go for this? Charge onto Mantis. He is hit. And just trying to get that spam of Ion Shell. Oh, God. Ring around the Rosie. Pocket full of posies. He will end up dying. They're going to try and get Dread as well. The aggro of the tower now goes on to Dread. Nihis will get that kill. Double for him. And manages to get out as well. Big save there. Bottom lane. Yara the Slayer. Going to pop his illusions and try and run ahead. One more hit. PSM. No, the wand saves him. Another right click from 111. He pops the ultimate now in order to try and still go for Yara the Slayer. Trying to juke and jive, but the Fade Bolt will wipe him out. PSM will end up dying here. but so will the Ancient Apparition. So a 2-for-1 exchange in the bottom lane, same thing as top, but this time in the favor of HellRaisers. Hook comes in. Brewmaster's still decently tanky and misses the stun there. Spirit Breaker still will be on top of it, though, and the Laguna Blade is up. They'll get this kill.
I've been caught off.
No need for the Spirit Breaker ultimate.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Radiant structures are fortified. Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
PSM looping around behind the top lane. He
Radiant's
hopes
middle tower has been denied.
To be able to pick off Nihis, setting up both Dread and Mantis. Dread is not quite level 5. Snowfinger of Death. Looks like he was spotted out, though. The Coon is actually going to try and drag him down here. I think he's got this kill. He's got his ultimate still, bumps him back straight into the Lina's right click. And that'll be a faster Yule Scepter for our Lina, who's already going raw movement speed. Bottom lane, Brewmaster is going to be stunned up by this one. I think he's still tanky enough to survive, but we'll see. No body blocking from Yarn the Slayer, still brings him quite low. Another Riptide will get the kill. Yarn the Slayer now has to try and get out. Goddamn, nuke one, and will be able to get it thanks to the tower hit and the creeps. Top lane, Nihis, action everywhere. He laid down the wall, but will be just dealt with from range. Good play there. From the side of HellRaisers, no charge, no money. It's definitely not going to be a kill. So, 8-9, 9 minutes in. 1,000 experience lead and a 1,500 gold lead. Oh, Mantis! He's got the Whirling Axes off, so I doubt the Coon really does anything. In fact, he's going to die. Hex 1, Impale follow-up. They'll take away his mana so he can't even charge out. That's surprise rotation from the Brewmaster, the tier 2 kind of catches him by surprise. HR do have the top net worth on the board with the SF sitting at 5,600. That being said, the rest of the troll is certainly underfarmed, at least for now. Probably because there's been so much action in this top lane. He's died 3 times, has been a part of 4 kills.
Dyer's
he hasn't really been able to AFK farm
attack
as much as he wants to. The wraparound with the Lion stealing as much mana as he can from the range creep. And with that telekinesis into Finger of Death. Whoa, there, Laguna Blade comes out. PSM does go down. Finger of Death is enough to finish off at least the Darkseer. Turn around, gets off the Hex. The Coon still has his ultimate, though, and he can use it on Mantis with Lina. Getting those right clicks in. They will win that fight. 10-11 now. HellRaisers dropping the ball a little bit. Yule's Vector is finished up on Goddamn, so that'll actually give him a little bit more presence moving around the map, plus makes him better against the Spirit Breaker's ganks as well.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
PSM. They can't kill Nagasen. I mean, they really can't kill Nagasen. She's got her ultimate. So she can pop it now if she wants to. She's going to need to. I'm not sure why she has it already. The stun goes out. Controlling some of these heroes. PSM almost dropping low here. And the stun comes out. Yarn the Slayer's actually going to die. All right. He just wants to prove me wrong, apparently. They will be able to get a counter kill, though, as the Coon comes in, manages to bump the range creep and run into Brewmaster at the same time. And Hook, with all the right clicks, man, you see in the power of phase boots on Lina. She's dishing out so much physical damage. Top lane, what's happening here? Nihis going to be cut off by Goddamn. And Nihis knows there's no escape, so he just turns and fights as best as possible. going on over here? Invis, goddamn. It's a courier snipe. Looks like he wants Radiant's the ancient apparition. He sees the Lina, attack. Though. And may be a bit skeptical about trying to go for this kill. But maybe the Lina. I mean, you can one-shot her with the ultimate and a close-range nuke, I believe. Goddamn. Doesn't see the opportunity. His allies were coming in, but they weren't fast enough.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Bottom lane, going for the gank on Yara the Slayer. He's got 1,500 gold trying to build into that Radiance. They start going on him now. They're going to try and surprise him here, but the ultimate has already
Dire's
gone out.
Top tower is under attack.
And he will get away rather easily. If they wanted to do that, they needed Radiant's to have either the Rubick sitting like back attack. Here in order to catch Dire's the Nagasarn as she tries to run fallen. Away, or
Radiant's bottom tower
they just kind of harass her back. And then surprise her with Rubick coming in with the telekinesis and the burst damage at the SF. It's one or the other. Fortunately, they kind of, wasn't really a well-executed gank. Mantis? Ice Blast will end up flipping him. It's not enough damage by itself, though. At least I don't think so. He's dropping low. He may actually die here. Last tick? Ooh, just barely ahead of it, that 10% marker. It's about a good 10 to 15 HP. Whoa, Laguna Blade onto the Rubick. There goes him. Two supports already down. Hellraisers on the retreat. As Hehe will take over this game and take over the Tier 1 tower too.
Dire's structures are fortified. Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Charge across, goddamn. Got a blink dagger, and Kuhn does not want to be diving to tier 3. Not yet, anyway. Maybe later on into this game they'll go for that kind of dive.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's middle tower has fallen.
Going out here, stun. Brewmaster may get popped. He's going to try and get off his ultimate. He does so successfully ahead of the stun coming out from the Kuhn. Try and slow down these heroes, body block as much as possible. The Kuhn does have a charge up in 3 seconds. He could probably do it in the bottom lane or middle. Whoa there, that was not the charge he wanted. He could have just charged bottom.
Put out to pasture.
He ends up charging back into the enemy team. Questionable.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
And now, time to take Roshan, since that great pickoff right next to the Rosh pit, might as well do it.
Roshan has fallen to the dire.
I'm not sure if they realize Goddamn actually has this Invis rune or not. Looks like they do. So I think that TP in from the Kuhn was just to try and control this. It is 17 minutes into this game. We've got about a 5,000 experience lead, 3,000 gold as well. That relic is coming up soon for Yarn the Slayer.
Radiant's top tower is under attack. Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Ice Blast from downtown. They don't actually have the Brewmaster ultimate. I think he's dead. Oh, Yule Scepter interception. Nice call. Goddamn, even threatening the ultimate. Just to make sure he's not going anywhere. They are in the Slayer. Whoa, boy. And that was some burst damage right there. Link Yule's is up. Brewmaster is actually going to be forced into the ultimate now. to try and catch the Spirit Breaker. Doesn't quite get him as he's able to use a crafty little charge to the middle lane where Mantis does have to be careful. Whirling Axes will protect him from the Coon. Yeah, sure enough, I think the Coon just overextended himself. He's got charge in 7 seconds, but the Blink in, Dread with the Hex, they'll get this go. Meanwhile, middle lane, Nihis going to be blown up by Goddamn. Right click. Oh, Nihis trying to stay in close range. Not much else he can do. The Yule Scepter goes out. Goddamn will end up being controlled a little bit longer, but Nihis will finally meet his demise. The Lion coming in, and Hook. What's Hook got? He's trying to build up his Aghanim Scepter. He's getting close. Almost got that creep.
Radiant structures are fortified.
Radiant. This is certainly an weird game, to be sure, because this game is sort of like Hehe. They're running around with this like gank, Darkseer, Spirit Breaker combo, and they're trying to get kills with Lina, and they're just generally buying time for the Naga side, but. HellRaisers has this very well-rounded team fight lineup that I think is still superior, even when Radiance is up. Yule Scepter coming out from... Oh, Yarn the Slayer is actually... Ooh, could this be their setup? Nihis doesn't actually have anything here, but he could vacuum. Oh, it's only level 1. They're spread enough they can't actually do anything. Miss stun onto the line, which is the one pickoff they could have had. So, yeah, unfortunately, all the cooldowns on their abilities... No Wall of Replica, no maxed out Vacuum yet. I would have actually liked to see only 2 levels in Surge, or 1 level, and try and max out Vacuum as soon as possible, because you know the Naga Siren's going to be setting you up all day, every day. And if you combine that well enough with the Lina stun, that's a game-winning combination right there. Mantis, SY, Lifesteal. Tier 2 tower is going to be taken by HellRaisers. They've got an Ice Blast here, but there's no response from Hehe besides that, so this Tier 2 should be taken out. They don't want to fight up against the Aegis. Makes a lot of sense. Hehe are just trying to play around that right now. Plus, they have the Radiance on the way. I hope that's Radiance. Oh god, that's not the Radiance. Naga Siren is still incredibly under-farmed, sitting at 6,500 net worth, while there's 9k on the Lina and 12k. On the SF. Lincoln Sphere for the SF. That's an interesting one. So no offensive Yules from the Lina. No charge from the Spirit Breaker. Yarn the Slayer. Do they actually get this one? Blink forward. They've got finger death.
To tame the lion.
Jeez. 14 to 19, 22 minutes in. Time to push down that tier 2 tower in the middle lane.
Radiant's middle tower.
As Hehe just continued to control the map. They've got Aghanim soon on the Lina. They're just trying to buy time, but it seems like HellRaisers, at this point, they could just 5-man top lane, get the tier 1 and tier 2, and be set up to 5-man inside the base soon. Of course, the SF still... Oh, actually, he doesn't have the Aegis anymore. He finished up his Lincoln's. He just dropped a while ago, I think. So yeah, time the 5-man top. Take tier 1, take tier 2, wait for the next Roshan, get Aegis, and then go uphill with a Troll and an SF that are really farmed. Who cares about the Naga Siren split push if she still is so far behind?
Radiant's
So 14-19, 23.5 minutes in. Let's just keep this conversation going. We don't want any dead air. That would be the worst thing ever when there's nothing to talk about. Oh, boy. PSM. Blink dagger soon. Dred's got a point booster. Mantis probably going to be going for BKB as his next item. You don't really need to upgrade the lifesteal. Morbid Mask, it's not necessary most of the time. Later on in the game, if you want a Satanic, go for it. Sometimes you'll see like early Vlad's pickup from Troll, but it's not that common. It's not even necessary. 10,000 gold lead for HellRaisers, a 12,000 experience lead. Gold per minute, almost 600 for the SF. About what you would expect with an SF has total free farm, and they're taking down tier 1 and tier 2 towers as well.
Radiant's top tower has fallen.
Set a Crimson Guard and soon to be a mech on Dehis. 24-minute Radiance with only brown boots.
Dire's bottom tower is
and a ring
under
of Aquila. Look at them. They're not even trying to go for these kills. They got to go for a sleep here. I think they need to try and sleep and get these heroes while they're grouped up. That's their play. While these heroes still do not have BKBs, I think that's how they win this fight. Brewmaster, though, has already found the initiation. Nihis with the troll ultimate going out. Well, goddamn's already wiped out the Spirit Breaker. Nihis already low enough as well. He's going to be right click down. Mantis is going to survive one step ahead of that Ice Blast. Yarn the Slayer unable to get off the ultimate. That's a killing spree for Dread. Lakota play stolen by PSM, turned around onto Hook. He will survive for the time being thanks to his incredibly fast movement speed, but maybe not. Nice turnaround stun there. Bring the Brewmaster a bit low, but they don't have any more nukes. It's all cooldowns.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
So tier 2 tower will be taken, 15 to 22. The build just continues to grow for HellRaisers.
Radiant's top tower has fallen. Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Charge? Wait, who's he charging? I think he was charging that illusion or something. Because the way he was running, he was not going towards the SF, and I don't think he was going over there. Rubik? Oh, sniped. Never mind, I missed that. My bad. 3,300 on goddamn. Wonder if he builds Butterfly next or BKB. Because maybe the BKB isn't necessary when you already have the Lincolns. It would make sense. Too many defensive items can be pretty bad. Roshan's going to go down soon, though. So next Aegis, push uphill with that one, especially with the Troll having his BKB pickup. Yeah, I'm saying let's just go Butterfly. Let's just sell the bottle, get an Eagle Song, call it a day.
Roshan has fallen to the Dire.
Immortality!
Oh,
Dire's
dear.
Middle tower is under
with
attack.
A level 3 Requiem of Souls and maxed out souls as well. This could be a free kill on anyone he wants. Nihis? No. Ancient Apparition? Maybe? Oh, no. Flat missed. TP out is successful.
Dire's top tower is under
gotta
attack.
Jump the gun there. Yule Scepter on Nihis though with a follow-up stun. They don't even need the SF ultimate. They just right-click it down. Wall gets thrown out. Oh, they actually do get the kill. The Illusions manage to take out the SF thanks to also the Ice Blast top lane. Mantis goes down. Hehe are beginning to stage something here. We got an ultimate out from Rubik. Nice interception there from Yaron the Slayer with that beautiful ultimate. Gives everyone enough room to TP out. Messy, very messy fight from HellRaisers, who lost the Darkseer, but ended up taking away the Aegis of Goddams as well as the troll pickoff. That's huge. Oh, and of course it's a Scotty for the SF. I don't know why I'm saying Eagle.
Dire's middle tower
Eagle
is
song
attack.
Into Butterfly, because of course you're going to go for the Scotty first. It's all about the stats right now, man. Coming in. Hyperstone. Assault here. That's what Hook doing. Yule Scepter. Into stun, Laguna Blade. Now finish off the Brewmaster. Beyond Godlike. Whoa, Hook. I didn't realize it, but he hasn't died ever since that first kill in middle lane. So Scotty is now here for the SF. They're beginning to have problems with this Naga Siren, who now has Boots of Travel. So, like, the build is coming up for the Naga Siren. Like, as soon as you have Radiance, your farm just explodes. As you can see, already has Boots of Travel. We'll start building into the Manta next. You still need your like, three basic farming items. Radiance, Boots of Travel, and Manta. Until you start building into anything that gives you teamfight sustainability, aka heart, most likely. So HellRaisers still have plenty of time where they're dominant in teamfights. But it's something they need to keep in mind. Well, that's a great start. A purely defensive
Dire's
ultimate for the Naga Siren will actually
attack.
Put HR in a great position to push uphill if they want. Unfortunately, they don't have the advantage of an Aegis.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
And this push out here from the Naga Siren illusions. Fortunately, they've got Lion who can deal with two illusions at once thanks to... jump forward! Is that a missed impale there? They're actually going to be able to blow up the hits thanks to goddamn Yarn the Slayer also getting quite low. Will be able to take him out. Hook takes out the SF at least. He will die for the first time in forever and a half.
Radiant structures.
Beyond Godlike spree split Radiant's between the three different heroes. He will be forced to buy back. Dives in too deep. They've overextended themselves. Now Hook could harass some in the back. PSM in the back. He's going to be... Oh, no! Kuhn! Couldn't get off that ultimate. Now all of his mana is going to be drained away. He's utterly useless. Brewmaster gets taken out by the Lina. Charge forward. Managed to get the Ancient Apparition with Mantis jumping forward on his Blink Dagger. Gets the kill. Back himself up through bottom lane. Nuke on a PSM. Hook is catching up to him. Right click doing so much damage. Charge onto Dread as well. Hehe are just cleaning up right now. HR. Man. Triple kill for Hook. You gotta give it to him. This guy's playing a stellar game. That fight did cost them a buyback on the Lina as well as the Spearbreaker, but it was well worth it, man. They got a lot out of that team fight. So many pickoffs.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Mantis. Oh, God. Yarn the Slayer gets off his ultimate and gets away, so he's good.
Money to burn.
Aghanims for the Lion. So what is that, 20 second cooldown now and an AoE to it? And not 20 second just yet. He's not level 3, unfortunately. That AoE, we'll see whether or not he actually gets any sort of
Dire's
real AoE. Maybe he's a lot of telekinesis. It's kind of an ability that allows you to group maybe two heroes together. Rubik, interception here of the Lina, will be able to steal the stun. Whoa, hold up, BKB from Hook is going to be able to blow up PSM real quickly. Ice Blast comes in, hits the pandas, but nothing else. And Nihis now trying to intercept these heroes that are coming in. Finger of Death on to Nihis. He will end up falling. Or will he? What? Oh my god. Nihis. He's still dead, right? He's totally still dead. Meanwhile, farther down, did they end up getting... Oh god, the Blue Master's dead. Yarn the Slayer gets wiped out in the middle lane from Mantis. Oh, I mean, they saved the lean up, but... Losing Yarn the Slayer like that, the Naga Siren is unacceptable. Mantis gonna join his teammates here in the bottom lane. The tier 3 tower in middle is lower, but it seems like they don't care about that too much.
Radiant's bottom tower.
And considering with the troll ultimate how quickly you can take towers. X there. Dread is overextended, I think. He's still got the Finger of Death, and he's going to need to use it before he dies. Oh. Dread. Way too ambitious for that push. Gives away a free kill as well as halts their push. So odd. Odd and unnecessary. Butterfly next for the SF, perhaps? I don't know. You still have to deal with this Laguna Blade. The pure damage of Agonyms is pretty rough. Do you need any more tank up items on the SF? It's got 2,500 HP. So obviously that's not terrible. Yeah, I suppose with the Lincolns you're good. Lincolns and Scotty, it's enough stats by itself. So you can go for the more right-click heavy Butterfly. All right, Hook. Whatever, dude. Oh, God, the charge! It actually bounced over to Goddamn! Oh, no! He was the closest unit in vision on map. HR, man. This is just the silliest game, man. Both these teams keep giving the weirdest, dumbest pickoffs. Ultimate's going to be popped here. Yarn the Slayer's going to go down once again. That was lucky, though. Mantis gets the bash before the sleep could go out.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
So some decent luck there for our troll, but they will end up losing away. Tier 1 tower in this bottom lane. Hehe are closing in more map control. We could be pushing this pretty late game as HellRaisers just fail to be able to push in once again.
Tower is under attack.
Now, that's not to say that HellRaisers have worse late game than Hehe. What's interesting is that we're basically relying on a Naga Siren, and Lina is... good late game, but kind of untested in many regards. BKB activated by Hook with the Laguna Blade, and Jesus. There was like no misses whatsoever from that Lina. Anyway, what was I saying? Lina's definitely better in the late game thanks to this whole Aghanim's changeup, making it pure damage. And she's well far ahead of most of these heroes, sitting second in the net worth board. So it's kind of where you want the Lina to be if you have to go late game. It's pretty good, but this Naga Siren, man. Still no Manta. Money, like, I swear to God, like, right now, Naga Siren is costing the game for Hehe, and Lina is winning the game for Hehe. Hook is just tore it up this game. Mantis, Ice Blast. Oh, God, it didn't actually hit him. It didn't hit him, and that will actually mean he survives, and he gives away Laguna Blade to Rubik. The charge is still coming in, but it's too late. Fortunately for him, Rubik is so low on mana because he doesn't have Arcane Boots that he can't actively use Laguna Blade and combo it with any other spells. 680 out of his 790 mana pool. Scotty, second Scotty of the game, now finished up on the Troll Warlord. I would love to see Lina pick up an MKB next, by the way. That item would be so sick. You're dealing with Brewmaster and Troll. Both have mispercented chances and most likely a hero that gets Butterfly eventually. We're going to see Assault Cuirass first, but, you know, I think Butterfly is inevitable right on the SF. The charge is coming in. Brewmaster's going to pop his ultimate. Naga Siren, the interception. Can they get it? Oh, God. It's going to be close. 100 health. They're going to try and take it down. The Aegis is snatched there by the Lina. Manages to get it. Finger of Death, a huge one. It's three heroes. It's now the fight underneath the wall. Doesn't matter. The charge over onto Dread. Unable to get him as Kuhn is locked inside. Goddamn, pops the ultimate and takes down Hook for a second time. Almost. Someone right-click him. Someone take him out. He will die to the Whirling Axes. Kuhn is trapped on the cliff. He will go down as well. And in the end, it's a wipe there. Almost. The Naga Siren, the only hero left alive, and I believe she had to buy back. No, she TP'd away. She TP'd home, so she is the only survivor there of that team fight, and that includes Selena dying twice after she managed to grab the Aegis. They also got the Roshan kill. I said snatched, and I kind of just meant that he was able to grab it, but that was also the Roshan kill to Hehe. Does this show Roshan? I don't think it does. Anyway. They did get that, but obviously the fight went horrible for them. And now that's... That net worth that was climbing up a decent amount with the Naga Siren finally getting some farm and the Lina staying well far ahead. That is just dipped down. Once again, bottom lane, we do have Mantis, who is trying to solo up the whole entire enemy team. Finger Death manages to finish off Nihis, but the team is on its way out again with this weird split push they do into the base. I'm not a fan. The troll gets taken out without any help. The ranged Rax is still live here in this middle lane. They did force some more buybacks. Lina had to buy back. And that was it, actually. Whoa. What was that? Ice blast. Oh, that is the worst. You die inside of the fountain. That is the worst feeling ever. I don't know. Naga Siren's such a hard hero to talk about when you go late game. Because there's so many different ways. Like, the big advantage of the Naga Siren isn't necessarily that you win straight up team fights. It's all the other advantages late game that Naga Siren gives you. The split pushing, the ultimate that is able to set up really good team fights. Like, let's not forget, we have some amazing late game potential here with the Naga Siren sleep. If you have the sleep set up into the Wall of Replica, hell, I want to see an Aghanim's Wall Replica, man. I think that would be legit as hell. You set that up into the vacuum into the wall. You try and get Alina stun in there. Spirit Breaker charges through some heroes. Like, Ice Blast over the top. There's so much potential for the late game to still go the way of Hehe quite easily in team fights, despite the fact that they may not have the stronger carry. Naga Siren, I feel, is outdone by the troll and the SF combined. One, if it was just one or the other, I think Naga Siren would beat them, or at least it would be a closer matchup. But because we have the SF and the troll on one side, it feels like HR have the better team fight. Team fight carries. BKB activated by Mantis, going to be controlled by the ensnare, also throws out a wall, the combo wall there of the Rubik. Gets thrown out the last second of his life. Mantis has to run himself away. Very questionable call there from HellRaisers running two heroes into the enemy jungle. And gets spotted out by Hehe's foreman. Money changes hands. Well, that's interesting. BBC will actually be replacing Virtus Pro in the D2CL. So those of you guys who are wondering about VP and what is happening there, I believe ESL is not, they are not being replaced at all. But in In D2CL they are. And that'll be by Balkan Bears Corleone. I've actually grown pretty fond of that team. I like watching them. I'm not sure what this smoke does for them, by the way. Because look at the positioning of the lanes. You see a common factor here? The lanes are all pushed. So if they get a pickoff, like say the best case scenario, you get the Naga Siren pickoff. I don't think you actually push in fast enough to make use of the fact that she's dead. So yeah, you kill her, maybe you take away some farm, you get some gold for yourself, but you don't actually get any objectives out of that smoke. Hook going for the kill on the Brewmaster. We've seen this all day, every day, but the telekinesis catch him out before the BKB goes off. He'll still be able to lay out a lot of damage. In fact, still wipes out the Brewmaster. The ultimate on the side there from Goddamn. The Rubik's going to be charged in. And Goddamn, I think he's got to get out of here, man. You got no support whatsoever. The Spirit Breaker, Lincolns will protect you. Mantis and Dread trying to charge down Nihus. He's going to fight around the wall as best as possible, waiting for his allies. Meanwhile, looks like some TP's back. Nihus does lose his life, though. So I believe they just TP'd out Hook as well as... the Spirit Breaker both TP'd out, knowing that they were kind of sandwiched by Mantis and Dread.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Charge, Scythe of Ice. Laguna Blade's not up for another 5 seconds. And now the BKB activated by Mantis, he will rip through the coon. That was questionable decision-making, man, on both sides. It doesn't even come down to team fights. It just comes down to, like, odd just choices of engagement. They didn't have the Laguna Blade up. Why would you charge the troll if you didn't have Laguna Blade up? I don't know. I'm not feeling it. There is the push in the top lane. The tier 3s are getting lower, and HellRaisers, if they don't get their crap together here, they have thrown so many engagements where they've been like, all right, we're able to go uphill. Let's do it, boys. And then they split up like five different. They like put a hero here. They put a hero here. They put a hero here. And then like one of them gets picked off. And next thing you know, it's like, oh, we didn't actually like get a Rax. All we did is do some small damage to the tier 3. Because our SF and our troll were separated on different sides of the lanes and couldn't help each other when the engagement came forward. They just outnumbered us. 3 versus 1, kill the troll. And then once the troll is dead, the SF has to back up. He's like, well, I'm not going to stick around and die too. I feel like it's been like a very innovative night of Dota for like drafting-wise and everything else. And it's been really fun to watch. HellRaisers with the Aggro Enigma tri-lane, that was really cool. We had the one position Treant Protector from Hehe with their global strat. That was a ton of fun, if a little drawn out and boring, but it was fun when it happened. But it's also been kind of feels like a sloppy night of Dota. And that is pretty typical when you get into some odd strategies, some heroes and some strats you're not used to, you will play differently. Or maybe you actually play the same and that's not the way to play up against that draft.
Radiant's middle barracks are under attack.
Radiant's middle backdoor protection or no, Goddamn still has enough damage to wipe out your range rags, which is low enough already. And now they're Radiant's sticking together. Look at that, we've got a full 5-man team here in the middle lane. He won't have such a simple engagement. Jump in here. Hook is going to be able to pop his BKB. Nice wall setup. The Brewmaster gets off his ultimate. The sleep goes out. That just leaves the BKB here. Still up. The Brewmaster as well as Mantis. Mantis' BKB fades. And they set up once again. PSM gets a stun onto Nihus. He will be taken out. One for one exchange there. Yarn the Slayer now going to be stunned up. Finger of Death. They're going to try and beat him to death with Mantis. And goddamn, they get it too. Ice Blast. Laid out. Hook. Looking for some stuns. Going to be able to get it on the Brewmaster. Able to finish him out. Goddamn slowed down by his own illusions. He's not making it out of here. He ends up falling. The rest of HR go a bit too deep. And man, fighting around that wall is so difficult. It's probably one of the reasons why they felt like splitting up in team fights, but I think, again, they just dove in too deep. They ended up drying out in this fight. They ended up getting in these fights around here. Like, this sort of engagement, and then you have to back up through the wall again.
Money to burn.
No bueno, man. No bueno.
Is under attack.
Ooh, could this be Refresher, Lina?
Bottom tower has fallen.
Refresher? Maybe, Lakers. Maybe. That's almost 2,000 pure damage. No one's saying that. Oh, Spearbreaker! Oh, no. He was charging. He was charging the troll. They were going to try and kill him inside the base. That would have been a huge pickup, but he got stunned by Roshan. They'll at least take Roshan. At least seems very likely. I don't think you can test a Naga Siren for Rosh. Oh god, Mantis going in! He's gonna try and do it! They already have the disabled token instant damage on the ground! Naga Siren grabs it! There's still a cheese as well, but Mantis just cleaning house. He needs that cheese. Oh, he doesn't get it. He gets two kills, but they lose two heroes. Lose the Aegis and cheese. And now, Hehe are in a great position to force a buyback on the troll. I can't believe he just tried to do that, Dread. Finger by him. Turns around, steals the mana away from the Yarn, the Slayer. Oh, and without any mana, can they actually get this kill? Troll comes forward, Blink Dagger. Get the bashes, boys, get the bashes. Yarn, the Slayer ain't going anywhere without mana. They'll pop the ultimate, that's gonna be Aegis. Round number two, do they actually have the disable fast enough? The impale gets laid down, can they chain stun him? Nuke's going out, finger of death, but the vacuum and the song goes out! The TP out from Yarn the Slayer. And they get themselves away, Nihis couldn't TP out, nor could Hook. And they will actually get a kill on both the Brewmaster as well as the Lion, and they're not gonna get anything in return. That wall just tore them a new one, and now Mantis, if he's not careful, he could die here. The first damage, Laguna Blade, not enough. Oh, God. God damn. He just destroyed Lina. Mantis now on his way out. Remember, he bought back for this. And he's being charged. God damn, he's very low as well. He's going to have to abandon the troll. You don't want to do it, but I think you have to. Bump up on the cliff. Did that save him? Coon, he's trying to save himself, but the ultimate is going to be enough to finish him off. And now God damn is the next target on the block, but he will blink himself away. PSM will die, though. 2 minutes down for the troll, 30 seconds for the Brew and the Lion, and a minute left on the Rubik. It's all up to the SF. He's got to just sit back and let them take Raxes. Hehe. Oh, man. They went all in on that Naga Siren. And if they'd gotten the Naga Siren, it all would have been gravy. But that vacuum interception was huge.
Dire's top tower is
and that vacuum wall just destroyed. I mean, that killed two heroes by itself. Uh-oh, what's happening here? Goddamn, does he get picked? He does. He's got a buyback. Brewmaster comes back into play. They're going to try and fight this one. Nice finger. Oh, boy. That took out some illusions. Unfortunately, the sleep just half a second too late, and the Brewlings do not get slept. They're going to try and control these heroes. Now Yarn the Slayer's out of this one. Hex comes forward. Surge is not able enough to get him ahead of that impale. But goddamn, Snail's trying to fight up. We have the Ancient Apparition left side taken out by the Brewmaster, who got a Cyclone up on the Nihis, who does have a wall, but he doesn't have the mana. He just lays down a vacuum of three-man stun from Lina. And here comes the turnaround. Yarn the Slayer gets one. They're going to chase down goddamn, who bought back as well. They still don't have the troll, but if goddamn dies here, this game is over for HellRaisers. Stun one, not landing, but they'll just run him down. Goddamn dies. 20 seconds on the troll, but without any support. Everyone is dead. How can he fight against the full five-man of Hehe? Unbelievable. Hehe, man, have been making waves in the MSI Dragon Battle with their interesting strategies, taking down some of the inferior teams. But holy cow.
Bottom barracks has fallen.
They just took down HellRaisers, man. That is something huge.
Dire's middle barracks has fallen. The Radiant now
of course, this is a best of three, guys. We're going to wait it out until the throne finally explodes. HellRaisers, I'm not sure if they actually think they can come back from this or if they're just hanging around. But that right there, that was one hell of an ending to the game, that's for sure. HellRaisers. Yara the Slayer's now completely maxed out. What a game. I mean, it was slow. We had a lot of sloppy plays and pickoffs left and right. And I really feel like HellRaisers could have ended this game a lot sooner. But because of their sloppy plays drawing this game out, still fighting around the throne here. Ancient Apparition, that's just so hard. They've got Mega Creeps. Kuhn is actually just right-clicking the throne. He's going to take it all by himself. A good game. Gates finally called. But holy cow, Hehe United, man. This team. I mean, I saw their cheesy lineups and I saw their fights, their matches up against the lower skill teams. And I was like, all right, you got in the finals. Big deal. But can you actually take on HellRaisers? The answer is a big F yeah. Whew. All right, guys, that is just game number one in this best of three between Hehe and HellRaisers. Get on Reddit, get on Twitter, get on Facebook, man. These games, they're interesting, they're fun. This game was like one hell of a slugfest in the last 15 minutes. Get out there. Let people know that this is going on, man. Forget about all the other games. Who cares? Who cares if Nip and Vega? You got big names there. Who cares if, like, I don't know what Star Ladder's going on. In fact, Star Ladder's not even going right now. Let people know. This series is one to watch, man. We'll be back after a short break.